Bo ten free. A što, što w norweszki bagel?
Tam mam
rysunek.
A što we tam? A burger. A, a to pizza.
Bo my mieli tego,
my mieli. Po norweszki?
Nie.
You're gonna wash anyway?
Yeah.
What type of pizza, though? The pizza is a little different than in America, but. Shake or chocolate shake? Huh? Vanilla? Vanilla? Chocolate?
Vanilla.
Chocolate.
Vanilla.
Huh? three chocolate, three vanilla shake. So, let's go.
After all, like,
Meisje Melken.
Meisje
Melken. Jankel Berkov. Dat was op Kalentijn, die ze gaf mijn hand.
Ja.
En daarna, Mendel Lewis. Er is een Ilo in Yeshiva. Ja. En daarna gaan we dan Nassim Shapiro.
Dat is Martin Spreekel?
Ja.
Nou ja, we zijn gesproken. Dein Bobbe Henja is mijn cousin.
En daarna gaan
we... Bobbe Gnesia. En mijn vader.
En daar gaan we Jezus Hemel. En over hier hebben we Schoenberg Baumgarten.
Mendelssohn?
Ja, yeah. Mendelssohn en Schoenberg Baumgarten.
Welke Baumgarten? Dat is Mendels. Jossi van...
Argentino.
Ah,
ja. Wel Baumgarten.
Vader. You gonna be by the wedding?
Which
wedding tonight?
Purim Katan, I think.
Purim Katan.
He's a... Do the Gensach Sunai. Very good. So I wanna tell you...
Yiddish is good and...
Babish Yeshiva read Menachem Yiddish.
Babish Yeshiva understands Yiddish?
Yiddish, they love me.
In die gassen, wo wir sitzen jetzt zum Teil, wenn der Rebbe gibt eine Jorn, ein bisschen älter von euch, wo der Rebbe die Ratte betiden doch. Der Rebbe organized an army of young Jews to protect Jews from anti-Semites, from pogroms. Und wenn ich bin gekommen nachher, auf Schinun, ich habe getroffen Iden, was haben gedenkt das, was haben gedenkt. Weil es gewann doch jemals eine Sache schon in Ukraine. Kazaken, Kosaken. Es haben kostet Räder gewinnen, Tiden. Und ich dachte, kostet Hitten auf Tiden. Und der Rebbe, mir ergänzt gewinnen, es ist called Haganah. Haganah ist like a protection. Für die junge Hebräer, starke Hebräer, Defense. Das protection is something else, right? Clay ammunition, not hot ammunition. Even though somebody told me that the Rebbe had a gun also, but that's not confirmed. They had the sticks, big sticks. And imagine now you came back and Jews don't need anymore to be protected. We can gain them with a Hitler, with a Yamulke, and the gain Yankiv is unbelievable. It read a lot machas. Because it says Azeirim Bedim or Berino Ikzeiru. You know what it means Azeirim Bedim or Berino Ikzeiru? It's even young Zeir Ashveret Kufa. For our Eden Bechlal, for the Rebbe's Mishpoche, Asach Mesilus Nefesh, Asach Agamas Nefesh, and Reb Leivik, Reb Leivitzch, Reb Leivik, and Reb Nistate, with Reb Tzunchano, Meisar Nefesh given for the Eden do. And it's given, Mamesh do Arum Avu Menorais, Mironova, Die hoe is dat voor Reb Leivik met Reb Tzunchano om die woon, mames onder menorah door, op die andere zijt. Dus van jene, je zet die wens in Dorten? In die hoe is? Van jene hoe is dat van genomen Reb Leivik in jail. Ha? Und ich habe gesehen, ja, das ist ein Mappe. Und ich habe gesehen, ein paar Mal, das Zell, wie mit Numen Rebleiwiken. So frisch sind ich das. 1939.
Did not you? No,
we have seen who. It's not a cell. The cell number 9 in the Martef.
In the Rebels, they come and bring in matzahs.
Ah, so it's not a cell. Alcohol pony. Oh, the ganze Stadt. Alle Iden in Stort wissen, dass sie da Rebbe und alle da sind Lubavitcher Chassidim. Viele die Goyim sind Chassidim. Sie nicht auch in andere Chugim, sie nicht auch in Isnagdus, weil er sehe, wie der Rebbe mit seinen Eltern und Meister Nefisch gehen und verdienen da in Stort, ist alle Iden in Stort seine Kinder vom Rebbe.
Warum
ist das nicht? Nein, ist nicht. Warum nicht? Because we...
Weil da lässt man sich mit dem Mashiach.
Mit dem Mashiach? Ja.
You know the story?
Yeah.
Who told you?
We heard about it.
We heard Kamagir says.
Yeah. But I want to tell you that Rabbi Telishevsky, he spent... How many years he spent here?
10 years. Not so far, but...
He has a big chelek in the Rebbe Hatzlocha here. You can see who he is, right? Crazy guy. Because he's crazy, he was able to have a big ashpoe on local kids to make brisn and to become balei tshuva. How many kids do you have now? How many kids do you have, your own kids?
My own four.
He has four kids, but the Rebbe says he has about 150 kids here. Baruch Nis.
You should understand something. The reason we have this camera, the reason we came over here all the way to the Nebe Petrovs, Kinder in Amerika wollen verstehen, als sie wollen dann 12 Tage in Tanja, wollen sie bekommen etwas, was wir können nicht kaufen mit Geld. Etwas, was ist, nicht, I'll go with Mami, I'll go with Tati. Sie sehen auf der Kamera, sie setzen mit Rabbi Kamenetsky und sie setzen mit Rabbi Bres und sie kommen mit Rabbi Stott und sie sehen, als nicht das Sache, was ich kann gehen allein.
Ich will euch sagen, sie da bechlar, ihr lernt doch Sides, ihr lernt Tanja, sie da einen von Emune, was mir glaubt. Sie sitzt am Spia und sagt in Joni, und mir darf glauben, und mir darf... Das ist ein von Schmier und Munde. Das ist ein von Rie. Was meint Rie? Wir sind mit den eigenen Augen, dass sie sehr sicher sind, dass sie sicher als sie nicht ins Fake ist. Und mir darf nicht beklall glauben, weil es steht einer der Schmier und Rie. In Dnieper, der Rebbe, ist in Eifen von Rie. Wir sind am Rebbe. Man darf nicht glauben. Man sieht in Amerika, darf man glauben die Meises. Als sie da eine Meise und die Maschinen, darf man oft nach ihnen die Emune von den jungen Talmidim so sein, wie sie darf zu sein. Aber ich komme daher, das ist ein Eifel von Rehe.
Sein Maas, wie viel ist?
Was meint das? Das meint zu sagen, als dem Rebenskehr, dem Rebens... Sein da ist eine Sache, was ist Poshet Benigle, Begilui. Begilui, weil er an nie, ich kann mir nicht maßbar sein, was tut sich da. Sie da, tuisende Rieden, was einen, was wäre ein Entre zur Jüdischkeit, direkt von Reben. This is your, this is the Sheikhs.
Nechten
haben wir gehabt. Und in Omhase, da in Stadt Eichet sehr stark. Weil wir nach Weisen die Jüden, that if you become a Baal Tshuva, you don't suffer. Versteht? Was meinen Sie? Wir werden a Baal Tshuva, darf man nur im Sachen. Wir darf sie weisen, als an die Welt vor, an die Welt a Baal Tshuva, an die Welt a Kost von Rebbe, kennen wir uns ein Geil um Hase. Das ist der Ruf von der Nord. Und der Rebbe hat uns mit gebench Gräse Broches, fragen wir mal, wir sind ein Rüssi vorne her, Gräse Broches, was kein Schliach hat nicht sicher gewinnt, als solche Broches. Tofschinun. Sie gewinnen es kommen in ihre Schönes, was der Rebbe hat nicht genitzt mit keinem mehr. Und alle Brüche sind mit Kuhem geworden, 100%. Was der Rebbe hat uns gewünscht. Kommen wir in Joni. Die Achtes von der Kehille, die Reichheit von der Kehille, die Erzloche. Keiner hat nicht gekannt, wie mit Metall sein. Als in Ukraine wird sein der größte jüdische Rabbinien in der Welt. כן? מתכוון אין האורם השטוב, אין האורם הפלץ. אף מיר אלמר שלנו מרחמונס גיאת, אז כבר יפור על הערב. מה אם בו בזה אינו מביבנו? מרחמונס גיאת, אני פורט אין הלוח. Hein Dnieper, dem Rebbe Stott, ist...
Hein Dnieper,
dem Rebbe Stott, ist Brochus
von Gilui. Kinder kommen von Amerika, sind Dnieper.
Ja. That's a very secret story. If you learn another 12 Brokim, I'll tell you.
Wie war Kupere da?
Where it is Bush.
David Bush.
Have your shake, mach a Broche hier. Oh, how are you? So good to see you. How long weren't you here? 10 years.
Come sit down.
That's shakshuka.
Have invited.
They built it, right?
Yeah, last time I was here with Pesach with my wife, and we got the private tour of the empty shell.
Kevin, I brought a special guest over here, Rabbi David Bush, a shliach from California, who also did 12 Brachim Tanya about that.
Yeah.
And
no, he knows the whole Tanya about
it. I don't know how much he knows now, but he's a shliach from California. Came special
very
to see.
Very successful shliach.
Very successful shliach. Came to see the group of Brachim having a glance 12 Brachim and to bring him the Eila with Rabbi Kamenetsky. Baruch Hashem.
Imagine the Mesirus Nefesh, the Rebbe Tzlachan, and the Rebbe Ked for the Jews here, for even though the Tzar that they had, the Agamas Nefesh that they had. They had Agamas Nefesh and Tzar, but they were never the Atzmus. I met people here when I came who remembered everything, who knew everything, who knew the Rebbe, they used to call him Mendel, Laser. I don't know if you met Laser. The Balagole, he was a Balagole. A real Balagole. He was at the wedding of the Rebbe without the Chosen Kalle on Mironova Street. He was by the wedding. He remembered the wedding, how they celebrated. Kilo the Chosen Kalle in the seating. Mamish Kilo the Chosen Kalle are there, and they danced the whole night on the tables, and they were so sweating that they took off their shirts. As they told me that it was such a big simcha by the chasana.
It's amazing that they're going to be here for a chasana as well.
Oh. So the kid that you saw that you're going to see today is the Rebbe Sakin.
That's
and the girl also, the Kale is from Kherson. If not for the Rebbe's Shluchim and the Rebbe's Ashpoy here, they would be lost. They would be lost, they would be going today. They wouldn't be... So it's a Shvokha Protis that I'm pouring cotton, you're coming to a chasana, you're coming with the right person, Rabbi Telishevsky. This is Mamesh with his Avos Yisroel and his Mesirus, his Ibergeirn type to the Shliches. He showed such a dugme chaye to hundreds of young people here. That as I mentioned before, you have at least 150 kids here. Bruchnis the kids, right?
I flew through Warsaw. So I was thinking about this, you know, like how funny it is.
You flew to Zaporozhye?
No, I flew to Kiev. But from Warsaw, I took a train. You know, here, Blidic, like, because of his mysterious stuff, she wasn't able to be by the
in Warsaw, person. And you flew
and
from
I'm
Warsaw.
And I'm flying from
on
Warsaw.
On the day of the wedding.
On the day of the wedding.
Okay. People here, the Jews here, are proud to be Lubavitch Chassidim. They might not be at Inganis and Frum, but they're all Chassidim of the Rebbe, even the Goyim. We have a mayor in the city. The mayor is a goy, like he has no chash of being Jewish. He's a real Russian. And he wishes he was a Lubavitch Chassid. He wishes he was Jewish. And he goes out of his way to help the Mazdas, you know, from the city budget, you know, everything that we need, he's helping. And he doesn't charge us taxes, and he gives city budgets. And for him it's a COVID, that he has the schools to help the Rebbe's Mazdas.
By Rabbi Chupin's house. He said a line over there. He turned around to the boys. He says, you boys don't have it. He says, you have a mama and a tate. He says, you have a fake Judaism. He says, I have only Rebbe. I don't have Chavnishke mama, tate, designers. I have no Rebbe. I live in the Rebbe's Stadt and I have only the Rebbe.
I was I wasn't, for a long time, I struggled, should I go, should I not go?
Yo, I want to tell you that for the chosen, when he discussed with me his hergeishim, the kesher to the wedding, out of everything was you coming from California. You know, he mentioned it to me a few times, that this is Shliach, he's flying all the way from California. And he wanted to make sure I remember who you are, so he started to be, I knew who you were, but he was trying to be metair. Agova shelo kacha, zakan shelo kacha, ta zocher mize?
I was undecided. Yeah. Finally, like Shabbos, I was talking with my wife and I said, you know, it's expensive, it's far, 30 hours of travel. And you
each
know,
way.
Like, each way. I'm going to be there for a few hours. So I said, you know, for my kid, of course I would do it. But I'm like, what do you mean, but? Right? Who's his father? Right, like, oh, you know, he doesn't, he needs that support.
He's giving you a broch under the chuppah, I think,
really?
Because of
that. Oh, wow.
I think you're on the list, he said.
But,
I want you to eat, chevre, go wash.
But really, it's Yossi's credit, because Yossi was in Salah with me.
How's his shake? The shake is good? You like it? You want to stay a few days, huh?
My wife was like,
you want to stay?
My wife was like, I should have said, we have a nice hotel here.
The first time I was in the store.
In the Crown Heights, all of them will want to come here. So you need to prepare $1 million for the next trip. Huh? What do you think, Shapira? How many kids are going to come next time? At least 200. So he needs to prepare a lot of cash. You're going to help him fundraise in Crown Heights? You're going to go to your rich uncles? You're going to go to your rich uncles to fundraise? Side, it's the right people, the right place, in the right time. And the right age. Because the Rebbe is given in your age. So it's really unbelievable. The Rebbe, Grace and Achas, yes. Grace and Achas. Right?
The Maimer Bat at the Tzava, the Rebbe talks about the challenge of America. Right? So here it is, back in the old country. Right. I'm putting part in it's a very interesting thing.
You have 1,100,000 people. Even though Rabbi Telishevsky already left some years ago, he's until now one of the most influential people in the city. Because of his Ashpoya. Why? Because he has Ashpoya on the Jews, and the Jews have Ashpoya on the Goyim. So he's on the list of the 10 most influential people in Bnei.
Now it's recorded.
I don't know exactly how to turn it into some big money. Because, you know, but really, Grace Armangelo. Sein Metzias, sein presence is still felt.
We have it recorded, it's good. Let's consult and done this.
I can tell you one thing. You know, in America, Eden haben Scheiles. You haben Scheiles. Was, why, here, the emuna pshuta that the Eden have. You tell them something, they believe it and take it. And do it. No questions asked. So the shluchim in the Rebbe Shtot have a very easy time with the shlichas. Because of the G'dushein, as Ozomim came of the Rebbe here, and Rebbe Levin, Rebbe Tzimchane, all you have to do is tell the story and show a dugme. And you see, you get 100% of tozaot, of results, right?
100%.
This is why it's easy to be shluchim.
It's the hardest thing.
You don't have to know nishkala mach, not lo lekalkel. You know what's the problem? Shav yashar. Zach shiyet rotzi li kacha liyot. Shliach tzach liyot im rosh muram. Im agav kacha. You also, Samuel, Luis, sit down straight, like this. I really mean it. Head up. Shluchim have to be with their head up. And a big smile. Always smile. Always smile. Because Jews want to see Shluchim smiling. Then they want to be connected to you. If you don't smile, if a Shliach is going on Shlichas, and he thinks he's on Mesirus Nefesh, and he suffers because of his Mesirus Nefesh, and we don't need his favors, let him go home. A shliach has to feel that he's the happiest person on earth, because he's a shliach. And he needs, this is the message that he has to give to the Jews. If he's sad, and he feels that he's in Mesirus Nefesh, when there's a farmucheter, and he's not happy, there is going to be no results. You understand? That's why I'm telling you, you have to sit straight and smile. And you also. Just as if you have those. Zitz as if you have a... We are hosted up, Zitz.
The trip would only work just for that line.
Yeah.
That's true.
For you.
Yeah, for me.
I can tell you one thing. We had here, in the beginning, big Nisienus. You don't think everything was this way like now. In the beginning, we had big chaves because we wanted to do what the Rebbe told us to do. We got into big debts. The KGB was running after us. They didn't let us do what we have to do. We came to our hotel, when we came, with big cockroaches and no hot water. And we tried to rent an apartment. Every time we went to an apartment to make up, the next 10 minutes after the KGB people came and said to the owner, if you give them the apartment, we will arrest you. You can't give them an apartment. Then we needed a translator to translate for us because we didn't speak Russian. So we heard about somebody very, very good who speaks good Hebrew and Russian. He was a Hebrew teacher. So we came to him. His name was Sasha Zamansky. And we said, can you translate? He said, are you the Lubavitch Chassidim? Are you the Shluchim of the Lubavitch Rebbe? We said, yeah. He almost fainted and ran away. So half a year later, I met him in the street. I said, Sasha, what happened? Why did you run away? What's the Gishen? So he said, before you came, the KGB people in the building that you visited came to my house and they said, we know that you are a Hebrew teacher. Then teach Hebrew. To teach Hebrew was against the law. It was still the Soviet Union, the communism in 1990, Tov Shinun. And they said, we know that what you do, it's against the law. We will close our eyes and not punish you with a condition that when the Rebbe's Shluchim will come to Dnieper, you will not have anything to do with them. You're not going to help them. Because they will probably come to you because they need a translator. I mean, a turgeman. So he asked them, why shouldn't I help them? So they told them, because they are very dangerous people. The Hasidim, the Shluchim of the Rebbe, are very dangerous people. The Hasidim, they said. To be accurate, they said, the Hasidim of the Rebbe are very dangerous people. Don't have anything to do with them. So he asked, why are they so dangerous? So the KGB people told them, because they are not afraid of anything. That's why they are dangerous. Zom nishke meire. Samay sushahoyo. I didn't tell it for many years, the story.
The last time we heard that story...
Before,
The last time you told us that story, I just want to tell you what happened the next day.
Yeah.
We were going to Kharkov for Shabbos. We sat by you Thursday night. We had a fabrengin in your house.
Yeah.
You told us the story. And then when we got to Kharkov, you told us that they said because they said yet net nikavo.
Yeah.
That was part of it. So we were going in the street, we were singing
that. That was my audition.
Okay. So listen.
Really, they said.
All the cakes and all the food.
I think they'll come, they'll bring now more.
Can I ask for one cake and everything instead?
Yeah. You can take
like a prawn instead of a pizza?
Yeah, sure.
So what happened? We went to Kharkov, we were walking in the street, and we were singing Net Net Nikavo. Mitamor. From Minton, they come and finish skinheads.
Skinheads?
Yeah, and they jumped on us.
What are you
they
saying?
They attacked us. Me, it was who was there?
I wasn't there.
It was me, Yossi Greenberg. Me, Yossi Greenberg. Mendel, no.
Didn't you go?
So you gave them back? You gave them back?
Bendels, the Shabbos. I had a castet. I had brass knuckles. The other guy came here and caught.
Yeah.
They got the wrong juice. No, and we sent them. I came to show, I was speaking for the students.
Yeah.
I came there in Gansen zu Blutig.
Oi.
Yeah.
But it was their blood.
I started speaking. So someone asked, what's all the blood? I said, Daigen ist nicht mein.
It's Nazi blood, not Nazi blood.
It's nicht mein.
Today, Baruch Hashem, there is no anti-Semitism here. The Goyim are very loyal to the Jews.
In Dnieper.
Yeah, the Chlal in Ukraine. There's no issues here.
Goyim.
Be upset. I paid money for it. It's Valtashkis. Chever, eat.
Can you ask me something about the cake?
This cake is called Pincher. It's a Ukrainian, Jewish-Ukrainian Lubavitch cake.
Everyone has to try it. You have
everybody
to try,
must try it. Everybody has to try it. And as I mentioned to you before, in order to be Mekarev into Yiddishkeit, you need to show them that you're not giving up on anything. Gashmias, Elom Hazer, Medaf Maila Zain Dinitzetzes, that shouldn't be that if you become frum, if you become a Baal Teshuva, you have to give up on something. So we need to make sure that every type of cheese, every type of salami that they're used to, we make it kosher. So we have a big production here of kosher products. So anybody who becomes frum, who becomes a Baal Teshuva, who becomes a Lubavitch Rechosid, can continue to enjoy Eilom Hazer and Maila Zain Eilom Hazer. That's why we built menorah also. Why menorah? I don't know, you saw it last night with the lights? How it's lighting the whole city? Yeah. It's, the idea of menorah is to bring back the Gein Yankiv to the Jews. They should be proud. Because, you know, for many years here, the Jews were in the passport of every person that says that said the nationality. Who you are, Ukrainian, Russian, Jew. If you're Jewish, you got bad marks in school. The anti-Semitism. In order for Jews not to be successful, they shouldn't make it to universities. So they would get bad marks in school, so they shouldn't pass the test to make it to university. But that finished Tovshinun Aleph. Today, all the goyim want to become Jewish. I love you very much.
You do gay?
No.
Yes, he's gonna take a video.
Yeah, hey, give me a
second. Are there any forks?
Naira in the world. No, the big one. The guy. There is a friend of ours, he's not Jewish, a big, very big devoted chaver of the community. In the beginning he bought a small one, and he paid mamash big money, and then he said, you know, it's too small, I want to make a bigger one. And he ordered in Eretz Yisrael from real silver. I don't want to even tell you how much it cost. You can bring here for this money, you can bring here probably 1,000 bochim next year. For how much it cost.
Giving him ideas.
No, I'm
he's
telling
planning
you. And... you know, it was a whole operation, how to bring it, how to build it. But it's a grace of Hikom. The building is our gvir. You know, we have to make money here. So one of the sources of income is we sell tickets to go up to the 18th floor. As a, you know, like in the Empire State Building. It's not tour, but we let. Other buildings don't let. Uh-huh. We have a system, we have a tourist information center, and we sell tickets. So one of our...
observatory.
Yeah. We have somebody explaining, this is the Dnieper, this is that.
You have the binoculars?
We have also a museum here, by the way.
Yeah, upstairs.
You saw the museum? Yeah. Very big museum.
There's so much...
cool, but this is the chair and table that they used to, that they had in the KGB building in that time. There was a few of them. I don't know if this is... I don't know. But that's the same type of chair and table and the typing machine that they used with Rabbi Levi.
When Rabbi Quinion was in court and he won the $21 million, whatever it was, that story, the table that they sat by, they came to the thing, he took the table to the Chabad house. Taking the table with me.
Basically, I didn't touch. So take another fork and eat it. It's very good.
What?
It's
the choices that these boys made, the transformations to their lives, it's like there's not, like in our language, what we speak, you're sitting at Farbanyan and you know, your mashpia is telling you, you know, take a achlata, sirambam, right? Go to mikvah, whatever it is, right? Massive changes in your life, right? You can't imagine, right? I mean, you come here, you look, you see the blown out buildings right next to this building. You think to yourself, who would choose that over this? And the fact of the matter is, absolutely, for these kids, it's a real choice because that's their family, right? Their family are the ones drinking the beer on the street and getting drunk and, you know, living life of nothing. So that's a life that they grow up with and that they know. And then you're asking them to totally change that and exchange it for something totally different. Not STEM, right? You know, they're giving up the support that they might have had from their family they're giving up everything. Undergoing a press, you know, whatever age they do, whether it's 10, 13, or some of these guys 40, older, it's the biggest commitment. And then some of these kids, they want to issue with that. And they become, right, the leaders of all of the, all of this is possible because the people that were inspired by the Shluchim here, they decided not just to be inspired, but to inspire others. The Balabatim, the ones that are responsible for the Shiurim now, the ones that are responsible for this building, they decided they're not just going to participate, they're going to be proactive and share it with others.
It's also they should understand that the Russian, the whole Bemis, the whole Russian Ukraine, the whole future is if the child's going to be an engineer. Bemis. If he'll have a degree and he'll be a doctor and everyone's going to recognize him. They're davening when he was born that he should be a doctor. And all of a sudden he has a beard. A beard means that he pushed in the belt. A beard means he doesn't have gel to shave. Like they're mamish for the parents. They disown them, some of them. They partially disown them. They and we don't have nothing to do.
Those that have parents.
Those that have, right.
Mendel. You can't do it to the Edel. It's going to be too much for them.
You don't need to feed it to me. I can eat it myself.
I'll split half. I'll go with you. Kevin, we have over here the most beautiful Menorah, sponsored to the Menorah Center. And this is made out of solid silver.
Enough to bring 1,000 more buckets.
And with this Menorah, we could bring 1,000 buckets to Ukraine. Please.
Come.
Wow.
Now you see the Rebbe seated from on top. The Rebbe stood from on top. It's like California.
It's 60,000 people.
3,000
people? Probably. It's a high percentage because
of the
goldfish.
You
can take a picture of the
book. Come. Everybody near the rabbi.
Yeah, but what's the rabbi to Lyshevsky?
David's going to take a
picture.
David can take a picture.
I'm a free agent.
In the middle.
Come to the
I can put on his head.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but that's a problem. You won't see the Dnieper. Yep. You know what? Come this way. I'm going to show you what.
Just stand up on top of
No,
him.
He should stand there.
Yeah, why not?
You stand here. So here you can take. You can see the Dnieper?
Yeah.
And then take the view of the city. Okay, the city of Rabbi Telishevsky is one of the most
This is right over here. We're standing outside Rabbi Kamenetsky's office. We're on the top of the building. This is the Menorah Center. This is one of the lights. If you look over here, behind us, you see the entire Dnieper. There's the river with the bridge, and you see the whole city from on top of the shul. This is an amazing feat. This is absolutely
in this shul, Reb Levig davened. You see in the shopping mall, there is two round buildings with a parking lot in the middle. Yeah. And you see the Katsubinskaya shul. You see the Katsubinskaya shul? Yeah. Reb Levig davened for 4 years. Yeah.
Where?
This is the shul. Yeah.
Where?
This shul, there is a little pink building. Did you see like a half a eagle?
In between the two towers? There's a garage, and then in the pink center of that, on the bottom, is a
like
little
building.
Oh, I see.
This shul Reb Levig davened for the last 4 years. From Tov Reish Tzadik Hei to Tov Reish Tzadik Tes. It's a shul now too. You know for who? For inmates. People who are in jail. We have a kehila for them.
Really?
Yeah. Big kehila. 90 people.
Wow.
We have a dormitory for them.
Big.
And this is the museum. The first two towers is the museum. And then did you go to Dan Makapon to Shiurei Teir Lubavitch?
What's your tale about it? Explain for the chevre.
Uh-huh.
Explain for the chevre what
it's
it means.
It's to be makar of young people.
And who does it?
Dan Makagon. Harav Agoyen, Harav Achosi, Dan Makagon. From the Chshuvei Achsidim, Ziknei Achsidim in Dnieper.
Ziknei
Mach,
yeah?
Menorah, this is how it really stands. You know, the location.
Yeah.
Which porch did we go out to? Nobody answers, only Rabbi Yuzevich.
Let's make this happen. The shul we just saw was over here.
We're going the right way. Which porch did we go out to?
I know.
Wait.
I think we went out from here and where we were standing.
Kolakolo? Now I'll give you, surprisingly, only one person in 10 answers the right answer.
How many people get asked
you,
the year?
If but... your ways won't work, you will find your way. You would also stay here?
No, I'll probably stay over here.
I'm going to
stay here because I saw the star in the building.
I'm staying here.
Not from here. Abachar Lenz 12 Prakim Tanya is from the top 10 from the...
This
is to scale? This is to scale.
Just...
I'm saying
this is ratio?
It's the right ratio?
Yeah, exactly.
So guys, look at this. The walls that we were just standing next to, this light, that's this. Right?
Where?
This
wall outside is the size.
It's an empty room. It's empty room.
It doesn't matter, but this, if this is the size...
Outside, this...
Look at this for a second.
This little thing. Look at
this.
You have big noise compared to this. It shows you how big the building is.
The size of the building,
yeah. It's amazing.
It's 22 floors.
Wow.
Shit.
We have 650,000 square feet. You're going to see tonight the hall where the chassid is going to be.
Where in the building is it?
You saw the mikveh? You went to the mikveh?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
25 given. Whole 25.
Over here?
Yeah, yeah. Just picked up the price from 15 to 25.
Just that we should notice that we're talking going to the mikveh because it would be 15 grivna we were in. You know.
99 cents.
Then they made me this table on a corner. But they made a mistake. They made it from the beginning big shorachas. One big table for one piece of wood from a big tree. But they had to, in the end, cut it in two halves. Who knows why? Exactly, they couldn't bring it in. So they had to cut it in two halves. And then they connected it together.
Still,
but it's really, originally it's made from, like the menorah, from mikshoachas.
Wow.
A very big, big tree.
Perfect,
can't
hold
out,
doesn't break in half.
You can dance enough
there.
We must go talk about bringing
it.
In building, we have 27 holes for Fabregas. So we don't have to.
But the coolest they do here.
Here it's VIP. VIP.
That's the
breath. Heinz is the fourth Purim cotton.
Yeah. You can go out to the other forge, there is another view.
Putre Blevik in jail, the communist Nimach Shimon, the Rishoyim Todd, they finished with Lubavitch, with Chassidi, with Eden. What did they get? The biggest Jewish
to base Asurim from.
And this is now we are building a base Moshiach.
This is a base Moshiach we're building in the city. Let me put on the light for you so you can see. It's going to be called base Moshiach for families, 130 apartments here. With parking, very nice apartments for shluchim, for families, for Lubavitch families.
Where is it located?
Yeah, next to Menorah.
Really?
Now we're starting to build already. This is the entrance here.
Amazing.
See? Wow. My mother is a drizin. A drizin is real estate. I had a building, I built. Whenever I finish one building, I start the next building. I have it for my uncle, Shalom Bert Drizin. So that's why I'm
talking
about real estate. We put binyan in Farn Rebbe.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. We always build something. There is never, we never stop building.
This is the Rebbe's real estate.
Yeah.
Okay.
After we fix it, this is Mironova we fixed. You saw Mironova, right?
I haven't seen it yet. I have to go. So they just made a
Yeah.
Where is this one?
This is the shoe like that I showed you in the shopping mall.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
That's after the remodel.
Wow.
And my daughter is getting married to Menachem Mendel Lerman. I don't know if you know, from Crown Heights.
Crown Heights?
Yeah.
Gershenson?
Gershenson.
Oh, no way.
You can see the weight limit.
What's going on?